shall rise to thee.
Yes, Lord, it does. To you alone.
Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.
Let's all lift our hands together and sing to him, holy. To this holy God,
there is an endless song echoes in my soul. I hear the music ring, and though the storms may come, I am holding on to the rock I sing. How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep from shouting your name? I know I am loved by the King. How can I keep from singing your praise? sing, cause you picked me up. Sing, cause you're there. I can sing, cause you hear me, Lord, when I call to you in prayer. I can sing with my last breath. Sing, for I know that I'll sing with the angels that sings around the throne. How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep from shouting your name? I know I am loved by the King, and it makes my heart want to sing.
The psalmist wrote, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. I wonder, dear friend, if you've seen the holiness of God as beautiful. This is the beauty of heaven, His holiness. No impurity, no pride, no self-seeking, no self-centeredness. This is the beautiful life. It's always thinking about the glory of God and the good of others. This is the beauty of holiness. Worship Him.
The beauty of holiness, we see you, Son of righteousness. So we bring all that we possess to lay at your feet. In the place where your glory shines, Jesus, lover of all, drawn us with love sublime to make us complete. So I pause at your gates once more as my heart and my spirit soar, and I wish I could love you more, my God and my King. So I pause at your gates once more as my heart and my spirit soar, and I wish I could love you more, my God and my King. Is there tribute that I could bring? Was there ever a song to sing that could ever express, my King, the work that you've done? Could I ever conceive of this, all the depths and the heights and breadth of the riches I now possess?
Yes, hallelujah.
Because of your love. So I pause at your gates once more as my heart and my spirit soar, and I wish I could love you more, my God and my King.
Sing it to Him.
So I pause at your gates once more as my heart and my spirit soar, and I wish I could love you more, my God and my King,
my God and my King,
my God and my King.
Read in Habakkuk 2, verse 20. The Lord is in His holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before Him. It speaks in the book of Revelation about a half hour of silence. It's good, dear friends, to have silence even before God, not just in an artificial way, not in a way that stirs our emotions, but in a way that says, Lord, who am I? Who is man that you remember him? Who am I, this man, this woman, this child, that you remember me? You are God in heaven, and here I am on earth, and so let my words be few. I put my hand over my mouth, put my face in the dust, and say, you are God. You are the potter. I am the clay. And forgive me, Lord, for where I've complained and argued and grumbled about your dealings in my life. I will see in eternity, and those who are in eternity now see how you have done all things well. And I know I will see that as well, Lord, when I stand before you face to face. Help me to see it now. Help me to see your love, your goodness, your kindness in everything. The good, the bad, the ugly. What the world calls bad and ugly, you call good, because you are causing all things to work together for good to those who love you and are called according to your purpose. So we praise you. Pray with me, family. Pray with me, brothers, sisters. Pray to him. He wants to hear your prayer more than mine. Lord, I thank you with all my heart because you are good and you've been wonderful. I thank you personally, Lord, for your dealings in my life. You've been faithful. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Thank you, Lord. You have not forgotten me, Lord. Even though I deserve to be forgotten and deserve to be cast into the pit of hell, you picked me up from the miry clay. You put my feet on a rock to stay. I praise you with all my life and all my heart. I will exalt you, Lord. Make it so. Let not anything on this earth, whether it's beautiful in my eyes or ugly in my eyes, let it not distract me from being fixed, from fixing my devotion on you all the days of my life. Let me fix my eyes on you, Lord Jesus. Let us fix our eyes on you, Lord Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who has run this race before us. Help us to see you seated there at the right hand of the Father, triumphant, having overcome, victorious. This is our King. This is our Captain. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise and glory and honor, Lord Jesus. We pray even as we sing to you, even as we pray to you, that it won't be to sound good, Lord. It won't be because of who else is here, but that you see the heart of praise that wants to praise you. Make us a people of praise, Lord. I pray that the world, when they see us suffering, will know that we are your children, that we serve the only true God, because we exult in our trials. We rejoice. We praise you. Nothing can steal our joy. Nothing can steal our peace. Nothing can steal our love. Make it so, Lord Jesus. Give us your Holy Spirit for this reason. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. I thank you for bringing us here. Thank you. I pray for any who are in a spiritual struggle, in a battle, Lord, that they're losing. Any life in whom the devil has a foothold, any addiction that binds anybody, in the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, on behalf of those who are in need, any who are discouraged, any whose eyes are blinded with the scales of the deception that the devil brings in through the cares and the worries of this world that choke out the word. Oh, Lord, come and remove those scales that we might see you, see your love for us, see your kindness for us, that we will truly be taken up with your kingdom and your kingdom alone. Not anything else, Lord, not the gifts you give us, not the blessings you give us, not anything earthly, not any earthly pleasure, not money at all, not popularity or fame or success, Lord, but your kingdom. Make it so, Lord Jesus. So we pray you lift them up. Lift up every hand that hangs down, any knees that are feeble, any who are have difficulty seeing you in the midst of the storm. Lord Jesus, open our eyes. Open our eyes. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your love. Pray also for our material needs. Thank you that you provide for us. We know that the jobs we have, the money we have to live is from you. You own the cattle on 1,000 hills. All the earth is yours, Lord Jesus. The devil tried to steal it, and he's the prince of this world because people have given it to him, Lord. But we've taken it back, Lord, and I pray that you will establish your authority, that your kingdom will come and your will be done in our marriages, in our homes, and in this church, Lord Jesus, in our workplaces. You placed us there simply to establish your kingdom. We recognize that. So we open our lives up to you, Lord, and we cry, fill us with your spirit that wherever we go, whatever we do, whatever we say, and whatever we think, it'll be your kingdom that's furthered through everything that we do. Not our kingdom, not our name, but your kingdom. So do that, Lord. Pray for those who are in need of healing. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you created our bodies, Lord, and you allowed it to sin to have that effect of sickness and even death, Lord, death as a result of sin. But you've overcome sin and death. And so on the basis of that victory, we ask you for healing for those who are in need of healing right now, some who are not here, who are sick, others who deal with constant chronic pain and sickness. Lord, lay your hands on them. As your body here on this earth, we lift them up to you, those that we know, that you lay your hands on them and touch them and heal them and lift them up, Lord Jesus. Bring healing power into their bodies. We thank you for that. Thank you that you hear our prayer. We're not guaranteed healing, Lord, because that's not what we're living for. We're not trying to preserve our bodies here on this earth. We're living for the eternal kingdom. We seek that our inner man will be renewed daily. So make that soul, Lord Jesus, no matter how much our outer man decays, let that inner man grow and build us up, Lord. Build this church up, establish it, not to be great in the eyes of the world, but pure, a pure offering, Lord, here in Loveland that's pleasing to you alone. That's what matters, Lord. We don't care what other people think about us or say about us, but you are pleased. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you that you've not given us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, a spirit of love, a spirit of discipline and sound mind. Lord Jesus, we stand against the spirit of fear in the name of Jesus. In your name, Lord Jesus, we bind any spirit of fear that's here, any spirit of fear that the devil is bringing into, bring worry or anxiety. You're with us, Lord Jesus. You said you would be with us. You would never forsake us. So we will not fear. We will not fear. We will go forward this week without any fear at all. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You've heard our prayer. You will answer. Thank you, Father. You've heard these things. Thank you that you said, Lord Jesus, we could come and ask the Father directly because of what you've done. And so we ask you, Father, all these things that we have brought. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Here's a simple chorus we'd like to sing. New to some of you. Sing with us. It's very simple. Make it so, Lord, that we will find in you our peace.
Hidden in God is our life with Christ in beauty and grows through.
Think about those words. I think about a newly engaged woman looks down at her, if we could go back to that last verse, last part of that verse, who's got a wedding ring or an engagement ring on her hand, and every now and then she looks down at it and thinks, I'm going to get married soon, singing with joy over her treasure. And that treasure is not something earthly. It's not gold and silver and precious stones of this earth, but it's a life in the Spirit. And so she fixes her vision on hidden things. All the others around her can be taken up with so many other things, but this woman who's been selected by her bridegroom to be married soon fixes her vision on him. Every hour, no matter what's going on around her, she's thinking, the day's coming. My wedding day is coming soon. And this next song is the last song we'll sing. The book of Revelation chapter 14 speaks about the bride of Christ is this. Those who followed him wherever he went. You read about a multitude in heaven, too many to count. And then you read about a countable number, the bride of Christ who's followed Jesus wherever he went. Let's not assume that we are. It certainly has nothing to do with any name or any specific church here on this earth or any denomination. It's a select few people here and there across the face of this earth who fix their vision on Jesus, who fix their vision on the bridegroom alone, or not taken up with the things of this earth, who are pure and chaste with their eyes, who are pure and chaste with their tongues. No lust, no gossip, no murmuring, complaining, no high thoughts. And if that's been there this week, oh, I implore you, I plead with you as we sing this song. God is doing a work in these last days, preparing a bride for his son Jesus, a bride as pure and holy and chaste, set apart and clean as he is. This is the bride of Christ, as pure and chaste as he is. We're not there yet. We see dimly. It has not yet appeared what we will be, but we know this, that when we see him, we shall be as he is, for we will be like him. We will see him as he is, for we will be like him. And everyone who has this hope fixed on him purifies himself as he is pure. In these last days, a work so blessed is wrought of God, O come and see. A body formed to Christ's own glory, his holy bride as chaste as he, his holy bride as chaste as he. Of this body shall come to perfect purity, two branches growing and maturing, deep in the vine they'll fruitful be, deep in the vine they'll fruitful be. Will you be with this joyful people? Do you know that your I, that self that seeks to sit on the throne, that always wants it his way, that's your biggest enemy? Yes, we have an enemy in the heavenlies, Satan himself and all his hosts. But the enemy that's closest to you is your own self, your I. I must have this. I need this. I will have this. I will do that. I will say this. Your bitter foe. Will you be with this joyful people, then hate your eye, your bitter foe. Purge out the leaven of your self-life, for narrow is the way they go, for narrow is the way they go. So run the race that set before. Following you, we believe it shall be so. Amen. You may be seated.